Oh, hey.
Hello there.
Wagwanji. Hi. Hello, everybody. It is I, Joshua Cobblepot, your host on this wonderful documentary. We're in a wonderful planet. Now then, kiddiewinks, the first planet that we're going to be learning about today is HAT-P7b. Discovered in 2008, this planet is approximately 1,000 light-years away from Earth. Due to high concentration of aluminium oxide in the atmosphere, it is believed to actually rain rubies and sapphires on the night side of the planet. HAT-P7b also suffers from violent storms, as you can see in this animation. Because of this, it is likely that the rubies and sapphires are scattered all across the planet. The next planet on the list is WASP-12b. WASP-12b orbits WASP-12, a star very much like our own Sun. What makes it so amazing is how close it is to the star. WASP-12b is 44 times closer to its star than Earth is to the Sun. Because of this, it is believed that the star is actually sucking in the planet at an extreme rate. This causes the planet to have a strange egg shape. The star is sucking in the planet so fast that one day the planet won't be there. Luckily, WASP-12b is 20 times the size of Earth, which means it has another 10 million years before it is completely turned to nothing.
Wow!
Right then, the next planet that we're going to be learning about is PSR B1620. Screw this. Who is naming these planets? I mean, if they're calling planets, I'd love to know what their kids are called. DC 406 billion C, your dinner's ready. Okay, Daddy, coming. Anyway, back to the planets. PSR B16. I'm not saying that again, you know the one I mean. Anyway, that planet is known for being extremely old, but not just old, the oldest planet in the galaxy, at a whopping 12.7 billion years old. Because of this, the planet has gained itself unofficial nicknames such as Methuselah and Genesis Planet. Now, before we end, there's just one more planet I'd like to mention. That planet is Kepler 16b. This miraculous planet is known for orbiting two stars, much like the famous Star Wars planet Tatooine. Anyway, enough of this Star Wars nonsense. This planet is real life and it's amazing. Before Kepler 16b, scientists didn't know that a planet could orbit two stars. That's what makes Kepler 16b so fantastic.
Well, just like that, it seems we've reached the end of our marvellous journey, and I just want to thank you all for joining me on it. With that said, all that's left for me to say is goodbye and thanks for watching.
We're in a wonderful planet.